If you have a small bulging lump on your wrist that appears to be full of liquid, it could be a ganglion cyst. The bump inside is full of jelly-like fluid, and it develops when you have a tear in the tissue that covers a tendon or joint. And the sac can grow big enough to start pressing on your nerves, then you'll start getting pain. Some people pop it, but you shouldn't do that. It's gonna likely recur, and it could even require surgery. If your nail is growing into your skin and flesh, well, that's called an ingrown nail. In severe cases, your big toe can get infected and develop pus. It usually occurs if you cut your nail too short, or if you naturally have curved toenails, or if you wear tight shoes that crowd out your toes. And if it keeps bothering you, a doctor can surgically remove the ingrown part of the nail. And it can take 2 to 4 months for the nail to grow back. In rare, severe cases, the problem can still repeat even after surgery, so in that case, the doctor can use a chemical that kills the nail root permanently. If you've ever gotten your blood drawn and the area darkens and bruises, it means your nurse accidentally punctured both sides of your vein instead of just one. So then your blood leaks and pools into the surrounding tissues, which is why your skin gets dark and bruised. But soon your blood thickens to plug up both holes, so then you can forgive the nurse. A doctor will give you eye drops to numb your eye. Then a laser will make a tiny cut like 2 to 3 millimeters at the edge of the cornea. And a circular opening is made in the lens capsule. So then they'll grab an ultrasonic device. And what it does is it breaks up the cloudy lens into tiny fragments. So then the pieces get suctioned out of your eye. And then an artificial lens gets put instead. And the amazing thing is, as intricate as the entire thing is, the procedure only takes 15 to 30 minutes. The eye is self-healing. So in most cases, you don't need stitches. If you have fatal familial insomnia, your ability to sleep worsens to the point of total insomnia. People with this disease, they have a mutation in a specific gene. It causes abnormal proteins to get created. So over time, these proteins collect in your thalamus, and that becomes toxic to your nervous system. And because of the total insomnia, you start getting panic attacks, even dementia. And it causes victims, unfortunately, to die within a few months if they don't get it treated. If you have a swollen, painful bump above your tailbone, it's likely a pilonidal cyst. Basically, it's a pocket of skin that contains your hair and skin debris. The thing that most people don't know is that, let's say you do extensive biking, or you sit at a desk for long periods of time, or you wear tight clothing. Well, those activities can cause friction that forces loose hair into your skin. And if that cyst gets infected, well, that's when it gets painful. And at that point, you can visit the doctor. She'll make a small cut in your skin to drain the cyst and remove all that debris. So next time you get an itch, just try not to think of pilonidal cysts. If you took all the nerves in your body and you laid it out end to end, it would be 45 miles. That's like driving the length of New York City from the southern tip of Staten Island to the northern end of the Bronx. Or it'd be like crossing the Panama Canal from the Atlantic to the Pacific. Or it's like swimming the Strait of Dover round trip from Dover to Calais, or running 2 marathons. So next time someone tells you you've got a lot of nerves, well, yeah, that's a lot. Subscribe.